गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द डीपीएस राव। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद द लेसन नंबर 1 विच इज बोंजूर। बोंजूर मीन्स गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू सम ग्रामर पार्ट ऑफ दिस लेसन। The conjugation of various verbs. First verb which we learned in class 4th, that was etra verb. Etra means to be. This is an irregular re ending verb. It is used most of the time to describe a nationality, a profession, quality of a person or outlook. It is an re ending verb, but it is irregular verb. In French grammar, this is the first verb which we learn. The conjugation of être verb is je suis. Subject pronoun je means I. Je suis means I am. Tu means you. Tu a means you are. Il a means he is or it is. Sometimes we use it for objects also. And l a means she is or it is. Now the plural of je suis means I am is we are. In French it is nous sommes. Suppose I want to say we are Indians, nous sommes Indiens. We are students, nous sommes étudiants. The plural of tu es is vous êtes. The plural of tu es is vous êtes. Vous we use for an elder person or for a group of people when I am talking direct to them. Vous êtes means you are. Il a means he is. The plural of il a is il sont. Ils is also pronounced il. As you know, the last consonant of a word is most of the time is silent. So il sont means they are for masculine plural. And plural of l a means she is they are, which is elles sont. The pronunciation of e double l e s is also as e double l e, elles sont. So I repeat once again, je suis means I am, tu es means you are, il est means he is or it is, elle est means she is or it is. Nous sommes means we are, vous êtes means you are or you all are, ils sont means they are for masculine plural, and elles sont means they are for feminine plural. So this is the first verb which we learn in French grammar, and it is very important to learn this verb because most of the time we use this verb to describe a nationality, a profession, quality of a person or an object, and outlook, appearance, how one does look alike. Suppose il est gros, il est mince, il est beau, he is handsome, il est beau, elle est belle, she is beautiful, elle est grande, she is big or tall. Je suis Indien. I am Indian. Tu es étudiant. You are student. Ils sont gentils. They are kind or gentle. So, être verb, you should practice it at home regularly. Second verb which we use, we are going to see here, is er ending verb. Now, in er ending verb, it's a group of regular verbs, the conjugation pattern is almost same. So first verb which we see here is parler. Parler means to speak. P-A-R-L-E-R. E-R is pronounced like A. Parler. Parler means to speak. Now once again I use the same subject pronouns. Je, tu, il, elle, nous, vous, il and elle. Now the conjugation of er ending regular verb is we cut the last two letters e and r. I cut the last two letters e and r, and according to the subject pronoun I add e, es, e, e, ons, ez, ent and ent in the radical which we got, that is parl. Suppose the verb is parler, so I cut er, so I get the stem P-A-R-L, par, and in which I add E with the subject pronoun je. Suppose je parle français, I speak French. Tu, with tu we add ES, the last two letters which I add after P-A-R-L is ES. With il, I add E, il parle. The pronunciation of P-A-R-L-E and P-A-R-L-E-S is similar. Il parle, he speaks. Elle parle, she speaks. In French, the simple present tense which we are seeing right now on the screen is used for simple present and present continuous also. Suppose if I say je parle français, it means I speak French and I am speaking French. With nous part, we add ons after parl. So it becomes P-A-R-L-O-N-S. Pronunciation is nous parlons anglais, we speak English. Nous parlons Hindi, we speak Hindi. The plural of tu is vous, as you saw in être verb also. The subject pronoun tu means you, and vous means you for an elder person, or you all are. Here with vous, we add ez at the end of P-A-R-L, parler, it becomes parler. Vous parlez means you speak. Vous parlez espagnol, you speak Spanish. With the subject pronoun il, I-L-S, for masculine plural, third person, we add ent at the end of P-A-R-L, so it becomes il parle, they speak. And with L, E-L-L-E-S is also, the endings are same, E-N-T, P-A-R-L-E-N-T. Parler means to speak. Je parle, tu parle, il parle, elle parle, nous parlons, vous parlez, il parle, elle parle. Je parle, I speak, tu parle, you speak, il parle, he speaks, elle parle, she speaks. Nous parlons, we speak, vous parlez, you speak, il parle, they speak, and elle parle, they speak for feminine plural. Now, the third verb which we are going to see today, it's habiter. Habiter means to live. Suppose I want to say, I live in Indore. So in French, I will say, j'habite à Indore. The conjugation pattern is same. We cut the last two letters, E and R. And then according to the subject pronoun, I add E, ES, E and E in the singular forms. And in plural form with nous, I add ONS, with vous, EZ, and with IL and L, ENT, ENT. Because I have the radical here, the radical which I get here is HABIT, ABIT. So the first one is JABIT, JE becomes J apostrophe before a verb. If it is starting with A, E, I, O, U or silent H, because H is silent in French and it is considered as vowel, because the next letter which is appearing just after H is always a vowel. So the first one is Jabit, means I live. With tu is tu abit, H-A-B-I-T-E-S. The pronunciation is same as H-A-B-I-T-E, because S we do not pronounce it. The last consonant of a word, we do not pronounce it. Tu abit means you live. Il abit means he lives. एल आबिद मीन्स शी लिव्स. प्लूरल फॉर्म इज नू जाबितों, वी लिव, वो जाबिते, यू लिव और यू ऑल लिव. इल जाबित मीन्स दे लिव फॉर मैस्कुलाइन प्लूरल. ए एल जाबित मीन्स दे लिव फॉर फेमिनाइन प्लूरल. जाबिता इंदौर, आई लिव इन इंदौर, त्याबिता इंदौर, यू लिव इन इंदौर, इल आबिता इंदौर, एल आबिता इंदौर. नू जाबितों आ इंदौर, वी लिव इन इंदौर, वो जाबिते आ इंदौर, यू लिव इन इंदौर और यू ऑल लिव इन इंदौर. इल जाबित आ इंदौर, दे लिव इन इंदौर. एल जाबित आ इंदौर, दे लिव फॉर फेमिनिन प्लूरल. दे एल जाबित आ इंदौर मीन्स दे लिव इन इंदौर. नाउ द फोर्थ वर्ब विच वी आर गोइंग टू सी टूडे इट्स सप्ले. सप्ले मीन्स टू कॉल वन सेल्फ. सपोज यू वॉन्ट टू से योर नेम इन फ्रेंच, सो यू यूज सप्ले वर्ब. सप्ले मीन्स टू कॉल वन सेल्फ. दिस इज एन प्रोनोमिनल वर्ब, रिफ्लेक्सिव वर्ब. देर इज एस बिफोर द वर्ब, एस अपोस्ट्रोफ. नॉर्मली इट इज एस ई, बट सिंस द वर्ब इज स्टार्टिंग विद द वॉवल सो इट बिकम्स एस अपोस्ट्रोफ. सो फर्स्ट वन इज जे मापेल, आई कॉल माई सेल्फ. तू तापेल, यू कॉल योर सेल्फ. इल सापेल, ही कॉल्स हिमसेल्फ. एल सापेल, शी कॉल्स हर सेल्फ. नू नू जापलों, वी कॉल अवर सेल्फ. वू वू जापले, यू कॉल योर सेल्फ. इल सापेल, दे कॉल देम सेल्फ. एंड एल सापेल, दे कॉल देम सेल्फ फॉर फेमिनाइन प्लूरल. जमापेल, त्यू तापेल, इल सापेल, एल सापेल, नू नू जापलों, वो वो जापले, इल सापेल, एल सापेल. सपोज जम आपेल राजेश, चुतापेल विराज, इल सापेल युवराज, एल सापेल अनन्या, नू नू जापलू सादेपो, वो वो जापले. सपोज आई एम टेलिंग नेम ऑफ टू पर्सन, मोर देन वन पर्सन, वो वो जापले, श्रेया ए रचित. इल सापेल, the name of two boys or maybe more than two boys, and el sapel, the name of two girls. So this is the grammar part of the first lesson. Four verbs we saw today: être, parler, habiter et s'appeler, in which three verbs are er ending regular verbs, and être verb is re ending irregular verb, and this is the first verb which we learn in French grammar. In next class we will see the other verbs like avoir. Avoir means to have. Avoir verb also we learn in class 4. So, and other er ending verbs, and aller verb also, which is er irregular verb. In the next class I will explain it about those verbs. Now culture and civilization of this lesson. As you know, in end of each and every lesson there is the part of culture and civilization. So in this lesson they have given the political map of France, and there are few information about France and Paris. First of all, they are saying la France est en Europe. The France is in Europe, European continent. France is the member of European continent. La France est en Europe. The France is in Europe. Second is la France s'appelle aussi l'hexagone. The France is also called hexagon. Now why it is called hexagon? Because it has more or less the shape of an hexagonal figure. If you see the map of France, it has a shape of an hexagon figure. That's why in French, when we say l'hexagone, it refers to France. La France s'appelle aussi l'hexagone. Maintenant, now, la capitale de la France est Paris. The capital of France is Paris. La capitale means the capital of the de la France. La capitale de la France est. Et means is, as you saw earlier in être verb. Être verb is used to describe also anything. La capitale de la France est Paris. Paris. P-A-R-I-S is pronounced like Paris. A is pronounced like A and S is silent. La capitale de la France est Paris. Paris s'appelle aussi la ville lumière. Paris s'appelle aussi la ville lumière. Means Paris is also called or known as the city of lights. Paris s'appelle aussi la ville lumière. La ville means city and lumière means light. The city of lights. Paris s'appelle aussi la ville lumière means Paris is also known or called as city of lights. So this is the part of culture and civilization which you should note down in your notebooks. Now, there is a small exercise. Choisissez la bonne, la réponse qui convient. Choisissez means choose the answer which is convenient. The first question is, salut, comment ça va? Salut, comment ça va? Someone is asking to someone, hi, how are you? So there are three options. Ça va bien, merci. Je m'appelle Nicolas et je vais bien. So as you can see, comment ça va? The answer is ça va bien or ça va bien, merci. Je m'appelle is the answer of comment tu t'appelles? How do you call yourself? So second one cannot be the answer of the question. And third one is je vais bien means I am fine or I am doing well. But the question of je vais bien is comment allez-vous? It's not comment ça va. The answer of comment ça va is ça va bien ou ça va bien, merci. So the answer of first one, salut, comment ça va, is ça va bien, merci. Second one, au revoir means bye bye. Au revoir, monsieur, bye bye, sir or mister. So first option is au revoir, à bientôt, bye bye, see you soon. Second option is merci, ça va bien, thank you, I am fine. And third one is salut, Claudine. So if someone asks you comment vas-tu ou comment ça va, then you can answer merci, ça va bien ou ça va bien, merci. Salut, Claudine is if you are trying to greet someone or someone told you salut with your name, then you are answering her salut, Claudine. So the right answer is au revoir, à bientôt, because the person is saying au revoir, monsieur, bye bye, sir. So the person is saying au revoir, à bientôt, bye bye, see you soon. So the answer of B is first one, au revoir, à bientôt. Second and third options are not correct. Now the third question is bonjour, comment allez-vous? Good morning, how are you? First option is thank you and you. But the first option, the answer is not complete. Some part is there, but it is not complete. Merci, you cannot say merci. First of all, you have to answer whether you are doing well or not. And when someone asks you comment allez-vous, it's a formal greeting. So you always answer with je vais bien or je vais bien, merci. So the answer of C is je vais bien, merci, I am fine, thank you. Third option cannot be the right answer because je m'appelle Pauline, someone is asking the name of Pauline. So the question must be comment tu t'appelles? So the answer can be je m'appelle Pauline. But here the question is comment allez-vous? How are you? Bonjour, comment allez-vous? It's a formal conversation. So the right answer is je vais bien, merci, I am fine, thank you. Comment allez-vous? Answer start with je vais bien, merci. Because subject pronoun vous is there, so the answer will also द आंसर ऑल्सो विल स्टार्ट विद द सब्जेक्ट प्रोनाउन ज और मे बी नो इफ वी आर आस्किंग दिस द क्वेश्चन टू मोर देन वन पर्सन कम उतालिब बट हियर द ऑप्शन ज वे बिया मेरसी इज द राइट वन. नाउ द फोर्थ एक्सरसाइज इज सवा फोर्थ क्वेश्चन इज सवा बिया एतवा आई एम फाइन एंड यू. फर्स्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑरवार. ऑरवार कैन नॉट बी द राइट आंसर बिकॉज ऑरवार इज बाय बाय बिकॉज इन क्वेश्चन इज सेइंग आई एम फाइन एंड यू सो द पर्सन विल से आई एम फाइन और आई एम नॉट फाइन. सेकेंड ऑप्शन इज सवाबिया मेर्सी आई एम फाइन थैंक यू. थर्ड ऑप्शन इज सल्यू. सल्यू इज द बिगिनिंग ऑफ अ कन्वर्सेशन इनफॉर्मल कन्वर्सेशन हाय. सो वी कैन नॉट से इफ समवन इज सेइंग आई एम फाइन एंड वी कैन से हाय हेलो नो. सल्यू वी से एट द फर्स्ट स्टेज ऑफ अ कन्वर्सेशन. सो इफ समवन इज सेइंग आई एम फाइन एंड यू सो द माय आंसर ऑल्सो विल बी सवा बिया मेर्सी आई एम डूइंग वेल और आई एम फाइन थैंक यू. सो द आंसर ऑफ डी इज सवाबिया मेर्सी. सो यू सॉ टुडे द कॉन्जुगेशन ऑफ फोर डिफरेंट वर्ब्स इन द ग्रामर पार्ट देन फ्यू थिंग्स अबाउट फ्रांस एंड पेरिस वॉट फ्रांस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड वॉट पेरिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड what is the capital of France and France is in belongs to which continent. Then the small four small exercises. So today we learn all this thing. In the next class we will continue with the other verbs, conjugation of other verbs and other things of the lesson one, or maybe we will continue, we will start also lesson two in between. Till then, thank you. Stay home, stay safe. Okay. Thanks for joining.